Hi, I'm Magdalena, and I'm a third-year international business student. Today we're here at the Academy building of the University of Groningen to show you how international business and communication across the globe can affect the daily business life. As the world becomes smaller through internationalization, international business organizations are affected in many ways. International companies are operating in many countries and thus have to deal with several cultures. One way in which culture is influencing the daily business life is communication. And today I will show you how cultures and communication differs across the globe and how those differences are influencing the daily business life. One typical business situation every company is facing is a negotiation. And who thinks that speaking one language is enough to be successful is wrong. Culture influences those communication processes during a negotiation, and it is very important for international managers to understand those differences to be successful. As we learn in our studies, culture is often described as an iceberg, where only a little part of the culture, beliefs and values are seen, but most of it are underlying and invisible. During my semester abroad, I was in Seoul, the capital city of South Korea. Did you know that for Asian cultures, and especially in South Korea, the main goal of a business negotiation is the building of relationships? When Western managers from Germany or the Netherlands, for example, are coming to South Korea to sign a contract during a negotiation, the Korean partner will not have the same goal. For Koreans, it is very important to first build a relationship before you sign a contract. So when the German manager is going to Korea to sign a contract, all he will get is a dinner invitation. In Japan, negotiations are seen as a win-win type of process. This means that in the end, both parties will be satisfied and reach their goal. But in countries like the Netherlands, Germany or United States, a business negotiation is held in order to win and sign a contract. This is very important to note because in the end, it influences the entire process of a negotiation. So the question is how to deal with those differences and how to communicate in such a situation. So after talking about all those cultural differences, I hope it is clear why it's so interesting to study international business. Studying here in Groningen is a lot of fun and you get to know a lot of people from different countries. During our studies, we have a lot of group projects and assignments, which is the best way to get in touch with people from different cultures and make your own personal experiences with culture differences in communication. To sum it up, international business managers who learn that culture differences matter and know how to deal with those culture differences can be more successful in their job. They can not only explain but also show companies how to train their employees and managers to be aware of culture differences and therefore improve the entire business performance. So I hope to see you all here in Groningen next year.